Good morning, guys. Thank you for joining me. Hope you had a good evening. Last night, there was 13 reports of seeing a fireball all the way from Florida and all the way up to New York City. Two videos were submitted to AMS. Here's an image of one of the videos. Yeah, it actually reminds me of an asteroid. And some reports said it looked like it was really up high, possibly at the edge of our atmosphere. Here's another image from another video that was submitted. It's not this white light here. It's this one here that's underneath the YouTube arrow. Chris from Middleburg said he thought it was a helicopter, but the oddity of the direction of travel and the glow of the light, plus the trail following, made me think otherwise. He also said it looked like a spotlight through smoke, shining backwards from a brilliant ball. Marcella sent in the one video. You can see it right there. Yeah, it looks more like an asteroid to me, but I didn't view it there. Many years ago, and this was probably 25 years ago, when that one asteroid went by the Earth and was visible for, what, a week, 2 weeks? I want to say it was Hukumemi or whatever. My kids were real little, but I got them up every night to watch the asteroid. The reason being, I wanted them to remember, and I figured the only way they would remember if they got up every night to view it. And it reminded me of that. Patrick sent in the other report. It said it was rather cloudy, so we lost sight of it a couple of times. My last sight of it, as it fell below the tree line, it had turned from a light blue to a deep orange, similar to a sulfur lamp. And they have a still of that right there. Jennifer posted from South Carolina, "We're out to watch the International Space Station fly over. At first thought the fireball was the station and thought, holy crap, I had no idea it moved so fast. It looks like that. What was even more impressive, through binoculars. Then we spotted the station and realized this wasn't it. Still not sure this was a fireball meteor. It looked like a giant flaming comet. Might have been something else. Wish I had a picture of that thing. The space station and Jupiter all together tonight. So cool." She said it looked orange. Sarah from South Carolina said only one or two stars were even visible, as it was a hazy night, but this was a large, glowing object moving across the sky. It was larger than the stars in the night sky, perhaps 2 to 3 times as large, but had no tail. I kept wondering if it would go away. I had time to look around to see if anyone else was seeing what I was seeing, but no one was, and then it kind of just faded out with a little wisp of a tail. She said it was orange and yellow, and that also came from, I believe, Pawleys Island, South Carolina. Christina from Yorktown, Virginia. Now, she said that it was orange, and it had a glowing train, and it looked like it exploded far away. Another report from New Jersey, another Christina, said it seemed to be in our atmosphere, or coming into almost. Which made me wonder exactly how large was this thing. How many near misses of large asteroids or meteorites that the government never tells us about. According to the NASA website for near-Earth objects, we got 6 that are supposed to approach today on the 16th. And then there's some for tomorrow. I'll give you a link to this page. It looks like the largest would be 31 to 70 meters across. So that one would be between 100 to 230 feet across. And that would be, let me bring this over for you. QV5. 2021, which means they only discovered them this year. And it's going to be really far out there. This is its orbit. It would be about 3.5 lunar distances from us. But then on October 7th, there's supposed to be one within the distance of the Earth and the Moon, and that one's small. 8.8 to supposedly 20 meters. So they figured that would be about 66 feet in diameter. And then all the rest, looks like they're beyond the distance of the Moon, other than this one, 2015 TQ21. And I'll show you the different ones that they got here. And that's all they have listed on here for near Earth objects, I suppose, for this year. But there's a lot that they miss and they don't find until after they pass by. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.